thing for someone to have answered prayers. Amen. And I get to a conclusion, it's not enough to know the word and pray the word. And I look back to the Lord's Prayer, he says, he has given up, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Then give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Then lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah, that scripture, there is that most quote of the word of God. Jesus is not quoting the word. But one thing I saw, that is the Lord's Prayer, it was a heart matter. It was a what? Most of us pray by hearts of men. We are praying in the Spirit because we are taught to pray in the Spirit. We are praying with the Word because we have only been taught to pray through the Word. But yet, we don't pray through the Word and pray in the Spirit, yet we don't have the answers. Now look at this, our Father who art in heaven, your heart must be connected. You call him Father. You're not talking about. So if your heart does not show you it's your Father, you will be saying, my Father is out in heaven, but your mind is saying it. So it's possible to pray with the Word of God, but your mind is doing what your heart. And so say, our Father who art in heaven. For you to call someone a Father, it means your heart is involved. I'm asking the truth. Your heart must be involved. Our Father who art in heaven. Then, hallowed be thy name. Amen. It means you have seen the magnificent of the Lord. Magnificent, magnificent are you, Lord. Omnipotent, omniscient. Hallelujah. Jesus. What is it? When you say, hallowed be thy name, it means your heart has seen the tremendous work of God. You have seen his mightiness. Amen. At the name of Jesus, you have seen things happen. But you only call that name of Jesus when your heart is responded. Amen. My Father was in heaven. Hallowed be the name. Amen. Hallowed be the name. Thy kingdom come on that as it is in heaven. You know, think about it. Your heart is involved. Give us this day our daily bread. My daily bread is a heart issue. Is it true? Everyone is waking up and going to work. It means their heart is cold out to their job. They know if I don't manage to get food, I will not have peace. So their heart is committed towards their finances they need in their body. Forgive us our trespasses, it means when you commit sin, your heart is the one which is offended, not your mind. There's no condemnation because of Christ Jesus. And I came to realize, it's good to pray with the word of God. It's good to pray in the Spirit. But ask yourself, every time you pray, are you praying to your heart? Because you can put your mind, you can set your mind to quote scriptures, you know that? You can set your mind to quote scriptures, very easy. But is your heart involved in that prayer? Now you want to pay accessory prayers. The question is your heart there or you are doing it because your mind has set itself? And I get to realize if you pray in the mind, you miss God because it becomes carnality. But there's no way you can pray in the heart and miss God because your heart, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So it means God regards the heart of a man as the seat of interaction. God regards the heart of man as the seat of interaction. God regards the heart of man as the seat of interaction. And when he wanted to anoint David, he was looking for a king, he was looking for a man of his own heart. Amen. David qualified because his heart was involved in everything he did. When he saw the lion and the bear, his heart was for the sheep. Amen. So everything he did, his heart was involved. Ask yourself, every time you are praying, is your heart involved? Or you are praying because it's your time to pray? You are praying because you are told to pray. You are praying because there is a prayer point. Yeah? You are praying because there is scriptures. Now, let us say, if we move on the scriptures, how will your prayer be? Will your heart still be involved? Amen. Heart. So God is looking at the heart. And I want to show you examples of people who pray through their hearts. Yet, some of them are not opening their mouth, but God has it. So it's not in the balance of opening your mouth. You can open your mouth, but your mind is not there, but your heart is not there. Ask yourself every time you are praying, is your heart involved? Is your heart what? Because we can come today, we put 20 scriptures on one prayer point. And one thing we can believe, you can be saying the scriptures, but is it true? But you are saying because we are logically wired to that pattern. Amen. But God is looking at your heart. When you are saying it, is your heart involved? Do you may believe? Because if you pray in your heart, you must believe. Is it true? The heart is the seat of belief, as well as the seat of communication. with the heart. You're talking about you believe with the heart. You believe, then with the mouth you confess. Amen. So with your heart, you believe, then you confess with your mouth that God will answer me. Amen. That God will heal me. Amen. So is your heart involved in prayer? Or are you just praying? Because I know the word of God. I was just asking myself. Because I was wondering, because most of us are the students of the word of God. Amen. We have been taught so much about the word of God. We know what the word of God says. But yet we have nothing to show. And we say some people will pray now for rain and rain will rain. What's the difference between them and me? And I said Elijah was a man of light consciousness. But Elijah goes from his hands. Amen. Let me show you the first example. Genesis 24 verse 25. This was the servant of Abraham was sent to look for a wife for his son Isaac. You understand? And the Bible records, when he was still intermingling with his hands, God answered the prayer. Amen. He did not pray this to them. So you can, it's good to pray the word, but your heart must be involved with the word. Amen. Because you must return the word of God to him. You must put him to remembrance of his word. Amen. But as much as putting God to remembrance of his word, let your heart be involved. Amen. Genesis 24, verse 25. And before I had done speaking in my heart. Genesis 24, verse 25. May God minister that our desires in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Before I was done speaking in my heart, behold, Rebecca came forth with her pitcher on her shoulder, and she went down unto the well and drew water. And I said to her, let me drink, I pray thee. Amen. It was in his heart. What is in your heart before you pray? What is in your heart? Don't pray because there's a prayer point, but what is in your heart? Because most of us, you are praying for church, but it's not in your heart. You are praying for peace, it's not in your heart. You are praying for manifestation of power, but it's not in our. But what is it now? You are not seeing results because of what? It is not in your heart. But you are reading logically. You are quoting scriptures. You are saying you are putting God to remembrance. No, God did not see what's in your mind. God sees what is in your heart. There's a Bible says the God who sees in secret will answer you openly. Where is the secret? The heart. No man can know the secret of man's heart, but people can know the secret of man's mind. You know what I'm talking about? What is in your heart before you pray? You know, you can do all the amount of prayers. I'm telling you the truth. But if your heart is not involved in that prayer, I'm making noise. Amen. That's why you don't see, after some people will see the name. This man, before he was, he had done, he was before he was done speaking. And God answered his prayer. Amen. So what is in your heart? What is in your heart? Very good.